You've tuned in to Matt and Randi in the Morning. We are here to encourage you in the Word so that you can be strong in the faith and live victoriously in Christ. That is where true victory is found. In our Lord God Almighty, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and to understand that He loves you. He loves us so much more than we can even begin to understand. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That is the meaning of Christmas. It is because of Christ. If you take Christ out of Christmas, all you have is Mass. That's it. Nothing. It is just nothing without Jesus. Jesus is the reason for the season. He is the Messiah promised to Israel, the Messiah promised to the world. God is faithful and true. Things don't happen in our time, but they do happen in God's perfect time. Today's thought that I had was joy in our journey. As we follow the Lord, things happen, you know, and there's moments that may come that kind of discourage you, and for a moment it may seem like you've lost that joy. But as a believer in Christ, we don't stay there. You who look at Christians and you have not accepted Jesus yet, just because all of a sudden you saw a Christian that didn't seem like they were happy at all, they seemed bitter and ugly for a moment, don't judge them by that moment that they were down. Look at more of their life and see how they come out of that. And how the joy of the Lord returns. How they encourage themselves in the Lord. Because a true believer in Jesus Christ, because of the living God that's in us, because of the Holy Spirit in us, we can't stay in that. The Holy Spirit will lift us up and encourage us. Just like when Peter was sinking in the water, Jesus grabbed his hand and lifted him out. For a moment we may be down, but as a believer in Jesus Christ, we don't stay down. We are victorious in Jesus Christ. God works all things together for the good of those that love Him. So we trust and hang on Christ. It's not on things, it may not be how we look, how we feel, but it's because of the victory that we have in Jesus Christ. The living hope of Jesus Christ that's in every believer. We know that one day He will return, call us home, and make things right. Just like He returned to die as a sacrifice lamb, just as it said in the Word that He would. He died on the cross. He suffered every prophecy that spoke about His coming here. Even being born to a virgin was fulfilled. And just like those were fulfilled, the prophecies of His coming back to take us home will be fulfilled in His perfect time. I've already taken 4 minutes, so we've got to hurry up in this. Joy for the journey. 1 John 1:1 says, "That which we have seen and heard we declare to you, that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son Jesus Christ. And these things we write to you, that your joy may be full." Why do we do these morning devotions? Why do we get into His Word? Why do we encourage you to get into His Word? Because in here you'll find the food that you need to remain joyful. It is that healthy meal. It is that fresh cup of water that you need on a hot day. It's found in this Word of God. Psalms 46:10 says, "God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with swelling. There is a river whose streams shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, and she shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nations range, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. We have a reason to keep our joy. It's because the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. If you've asked Jesus Christ to be Lord and Savior of your life, and you truly mean it, if your heart is toward Him, toward seeking Him, no matter what comes your way, you will be rescued by our Lord. He is your strength. He is your refuge. He's your hiding place. God is with us. John 15:9, as a father loved me, I also have loved you. This is Jesus speaking. As a father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. Stay in the love of the Lord. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. You see, following his word will help you keep with Christ. It will help you be full of the joy of the Lord, because there is joy in Christ. Jeremiah 15. And Jeremiah lived at a very hard time. I mean, he's also called the weeping prophet. But yet listen to these words that he wrote. Your words were found, and I ate them. Like I said, this is the bread of life. And your word was to me the joy and rejoicing of my heart. For I am called by your name, O Lord God of hosts. Jeremiah could say that in the horrible times that he was in. You too can say that. I too can say that. Your word was to me the joy and rejoicing of my heart. For I am called by your name. We are called by the name of Jesus, Yeshua Messiah, our Lord of hosts. I found some things that A.W. Pink had said about joy. He says, the ungodly are ever seeking after joy. Did you get that? The ungodly are ever seeking after joy, but they do not find it. They busy and weary themselves in the pursuit of it, yet all in vain. Their hearts being turned from the Lord, they look downward for joy, where it is not. Rejecting the substance, they diligently run after the shadow, only to be mocked by it. It is a sovereign decree of heaven that nothing can make sinners truly happy but God in Christ. But this they will not believe, and therefore they go from creature to creature, from one broken system to another, inquiring where the best joy is to be found. Each worldly thing which attracts them says, oh, it's found in me, but soon it disappoints. Nevertheless, they go on seeking it afresh today in the very thing which deceived them yesterday. If after many trials they discover the emptiness of one creature comfort, then they turn to another, only to verify our Lord's word, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. Nothing in this world will satisfy the thirst that God has put in you for him. It's only found in Jesus Christ. Rejoice evermore, 1 Thessalonians 5:16. It surely cannot be unsafe to do what... This is again... I am out of time. This is still Pink saying this. It surely cannot be unsafe to do what God has commanded us. The Lord has placed no embargo on rejoicing. No, it is Satan who strives to make us hang up our harps. There is no precept in Scripture binding us, grieve in the Lord always, and again I say grieve. But there is an exhortation which bids us, rejoice in the Lord, O ye righteous. For praise is comely for the upright. If you are a real Christian and it is a high time you tested yourself by Scripture and make sure of this point, then Christ is yours. All that is in him is yours. He bids you, eat, O friends, drink ye, drink abundantly, O beloved. That was in Solomon's 5:1. The only sin you may commit against his banquet of love is to stint yourself. Let your soul delight itself in fatness. Isaiah 55:2. Is spoken not to those already in heaven, but to the saints still on earth. It is not a carnal joy which we are here urging, by which we mean a joy which comes from carnal sources. It is useless to seek joy in earthly riches, for frequently they take themselves wings and fly away. Some seek their joy in their family circle, but that remains entire for only a few years at most. No, if we are to rejoice evermore, it must be in the object that lasts forever. Nor is it fanatical joy we have reference to. There are some with excitable natures who are happy only when they are half out of their minds. But terrible is this reaction. No, it is not an intelligent, steady heart. It is an intelligent, steady heart. Delight in God himself, every attribute of God, when contemplated by faith, will make the heart sing. Every doctrine of the gospel, when truly apprehended, will call for gladness and praise. True, I cannot help being sorrowful in the presence of sorrowful thoughts, but I can refuse to let my mind dwell on them. You know how I say, don't let the bird build that nest? Don't let the things of this world, the sorrows, the bitterness, build a nest and you cut it off. No, not on me. And instead, rejoice in the Lord. I can seek grace to meditate upon his goodness, his promises, the glorious future awaiting me. I have to decide whether I will go and stand in the light or hide among the shadows. Not to rejoice in the Lord is more than a misfortune. It is a fault, which needs to be confessed and forsaken. And then I put down Philippians 4:1. We know this. Therefore, my beloved, long for brethren, my joy and crown, so stand fast in the Lord, beloved. The rest of my fellow workers whose names are in the book of life. Is your name in the book of life? Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. So, keep a praise song in your heart. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. Christmas is a time to remember the greatest gift given to man, and that is Jesus Christ, the one who can reconcile us to God Almighty, the one who so dearly loves you. Keep that praise song or worship song in your heart. Sometimes you may not feel like a praise, but begin to worship God for who he is, and eventually it'll turn into a praise, because you realize the goodness of God upon your life. We'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy the presence of the Lord.